Everybody, this is Chisbert. Welcome back to Harvest Moon DS. And here we go. Dum da da da. Good morning, Chisba. How are you getting used to life here, Chisba? I came to ask a favor. Huh? How do I know your name? I know just about everything important, silly. Let me introduce myself. I am the Harvest Goddess. Yes, this is the Harvest Goddess of Harvest Moon. So about that favor. You know that the mayors of Bluebell and Konohana don't get along, right? Yeah, no kidding. It's not that they have any good reason to dislike each other. I guess you could just say that it's a tradition. The mayors of the two villages have hated each other for generations. But it wasn't always that way. They used to get along so well. Hundreds of years ago. Yeah, hundreds of years ago. This is the tunnel that Ina was talking about. People used to be able to come back and forth between Bluebell and Konohana. But it's just one day, the fighting started. Be a tunnel connecting the two villages. People traveled between the villages all the time, but then the fighting started. What did you say? Are you trying to insult my village's cooking? You can take your idiotic opinion right back to Konohana. I'm not trying to insult Bluebell, I'm just saying our cooking is better. If you can't see that, you're the one who's an idiot. Mayors, please calm down. Shut up, you all just be quiet. What's that? Looks like we startled the bats. Hey, you two, keep it down. I'm not putting up with all this shouting. I need my beauty sleep, you know. If you two hate each other so much, I'll just close this tunnel. Now you won't have to see each other at all. Oomph! What's happening? Is it an earthquake? Your yelling has angered the Harvest Goddess. What? You were yelling a lot louder than I was. This isn't the time to be arguing. We have to get out of here before it gets worse. There you have it. I was so mad I closed up the tunnel. But now I feel kind of bad about it. But it's a lot of work to put it all back like it was. And that's why I want you to do it for me, Chisba. Huh? But if you just reopen the tunnel, they'll start fighting again. So get them to be friends first, okay? 4 times a month, they hold a cooking festival on top of the mountain. I think that would be your best bet. It's the only time the two villages get together. If you can cook something delicious and help your village win, I'm sure that the males will see how great both villages are and become friends. I'm counting on you. Toodles! No pressure! And I got a lot of money. Oh yeah! Look what's gonna happen. Our horse is all better now. How are you doing, Chisba? I have something to give you. Huh? Well, you know your horse was injured in that fall? On top of that, your cart got broken. Your horse should be okay now. It looks like it made a full recovery. And I was able to get you a new cart. Use it well.
Thank you.
What's the name of your horse? The name of my horse is... Silver. Yes. Silver, that's a great name. Do you want me to teach you how to take care of your horse and cart? No, thank you. Okay then, if you ever have any problems with your cart, you can always ask me. Oh, and by the way, let me give you a piece of advice. Sometimes you'll find yourself with lots of items to deliver to people. That's when the cart really comes in handy. Be careful though, if you leave your cart behind, you won't be able to access any of the items left in it. Okay. Well, that's all. Good luck, Chisba. So yes, we now have our horse and cart. So what we're gonna do... is water our crops. And now we are going to go get our horse, who's in here. Now, in previous games, the horse you had to take care of as well. In this game, the horse is kind of superfluous, really. It's literally only there to carry, to basically move your cart around. And as a faster mode of traveling. It's not, you don't have to raise its friendship or anything like that, so... it's not as important as your livestock, it's just something to keep in mind. Morning, Chisba, want to do some panda exercises with me? No, I was just checking on you. If you want to be friends, you have to raise a friendship with people, obviously. So, even if you don't have any gifts or don't know what gifts to give people. Oh, hold on. Hey, Chisba, perfect timing. Huh? I got some useful info to tell you about horses and carts. Maybe you already know this info. Still want me to explain? No, I'm good. Great, feel free to have a look around my shop then. If you want, you can take a look around at the horses and stuff. Okay. So basically... I completely lost my train of thought. Thank you, Kana. Jerk. Yeah, if you don't know what to, what your village is like, you can just talk to them. As long as you talk to them once every day, you will raise your friendship points with them slightly. And eventually they'll tell you what stuff they like so that you can give them gifts. So, like I said, even if you don't... Now you see here, he said, please don't confuse me with my brothers. He actually has two brothers. He's one third of a set of triplets. And the only way you can distinguish them is by the colours they wear. So Raul wears red and orange. There's also Diego and Enrique. I cannot remember which colours each of them wear, but oh well. So, yeah, it's always important to raise your friendship with people. Because certain things... like, I believe Sheng can only upgrade your weapons if you have, like, a certain level of friendship with him. Same with pretty much anyone, and also friendship points are important for marriage candidates. Now, if you remember, Gombe likes critters. Pretty much any type of critter. Good morning, you look busy. But you can spare some time to tell an old man a joke, can't you? Ah, Chispa, you know what I like. Hee hee, this old man is happy. Right, now you see the flowers on the side of the bar? That represents your friendship points. Oh, everyone starts off at like one flower, I believe. Right, where's Nori? Nori's here. So everyone pretty much starts off at one heart. And as you hit thresholds for friendship points, you will you'll get more flowers. Right. So actually I think I can do the Gombe one now because I think I actually killed a small white. Alright. Ah, you came for me to teach you jumping critter catching. Ah, fine then, this man can teach you all you need to know. I already know, so... Just like its name suggests, the butterfly I requested is white. It's a common white, I believe, is what he wanted. I think I already caught one. Oh, I think I already gave it to him. Whoops. That was a bit of a slip up. Alright. So. You notice we didn't talk to Rahi yet, but it's fine. We need to go into the mountains today. There's some mint, so I can fulfill Reina's request. Some bamboo, so I can fulfill Ayami's request. Okay. Branches and rocks you always want to try and pick up when you can. And you always want to have old balls as well. Like I said, it's pretty much just anything you can pick up, like bugs, fish, or any kind of foraging stuff you should pick up. Because you never know when it'll come in handy. And that's how you do it. If you press it right, you'll actually land properly rather than going plummeting straight into the tree. I can usually pull it off with the long one, but the shorter ones are... Gotcha. Alrighty then. I think we've pretty much gotten everything we need, but... Ah, there we go. Small white. That's what we needed for Gombe. Should have actually paid attention to the one I gave him yesterday. Because I guarantee you I gave him the small white that I had yesterday, so... Got a swallowtail. Alright, so we'll go up to this foraging spot. See if we can get an ore stone today. Oh, magic blue flower. Those are actually rare. The magic blue flowers and the magic red flowers are actually pretty rare, so to get one like that, you always want to keep them. Alright, another branch. Branches and rocks actually have practical uses. That was a golden bug because it flew away so quickly. Oops. Oh, if you want to be friends with animals, like first off, you just pick them up. That'll get them accustomed to you. Even the wildlife animals have friendship points. But you don't want to throw stuff in, like, rivers or stuff, because that will decrease an animal wildlife's liking of you. And also, you don't want to hit anything with tools, because they will hate you for it. Right. So now I think we've got pretty much everything we needed. Oh. Rahi. Hi, Chispa. People say I should act more like a kid. What do they mean by that? Rahi actually acts pretty mature for his age. Alright, Gombe's right here. Gombe is also very childlike. He loves, like, having fun like a child would. And, like, this is the perfect thing. The other day when I was playing hide and seek with Rahi here, Ina got mad, hmm? Ah, she shouldn't let herself get that mad. She'll get more wrinkles. Love Gombe. Woo-wee! Caught that flittery critter, did ya? Ah, let me see it. Ah, that's the one. Congratulations. You're a capable one, aren't you? I'm surprised. You must be a critter lover, Chispa. Some critters are quite hard to find, but try to catch them all. Ah, you fulfilled my request, so here's your reward. He gave me some rice flour today. Now, rice flour, I'm actually going, just like the fish paste I did yesterday, I'm actually going to put that in the shipping bin to get some more money. Because we still can't buy, we still can't buy seeds until tomorrow, so it's a bit of a pain in the tush. Alright. Today, she's organizing all of her samples for analysis. She goes to town hall for reference materials that she doesn't have at home. Most of the time, Marina will actually, yeah, there you go. She always goes into the mountains to search for plants and flowers. There are only a couple of days a week where she actually stays indoors. So I already know this, it's just more tutorial stuff. So now, she wanted one mint and one chamomile. It's always best to give her the maximum freshness that you can. You'll get more friend points for it. Besides these herbs, I bet you found a lot of other things too, right? Bamboo shoots sprout during the season along with mushrooms and chestnuts. There are many cooking ingredients out there. Try to find them all. Well, here's your reward for fulfilling my request. Just select your reward from the reward screen and move it to your bag. Now, what she's given us is only available during winter or fall, I can't remember which, but it's lavender. Get rid of it during the winter. Doesn't it smell great? You can use lavender and the herbs I requested, which is mint and chamomile, in cooking. They make a very aromatic herb salad. You should try making it. I know life on the farm is hard work, so do your best. Rain. Now we go to talk to Ayami. What's up? You feeling ill? No? That's good. Talk about the request. Oh no! I bet you want to know, huh? No, I'm good. Really? Well, why don't you practice on me if you already know? Bring me what's in my request so I'll like you more. I'll be waiting. She was basically gonna teach us how to make friends by giving them gifts. Now, the reason why I said oh no is because I forgot to get the shiitake out. What's up? Okay. Talk about the request. Great, you bought them. Thank you. So, she wanted a bamboo and one shiitake. Give the requested items. I believe she gives us a couple of potato seeds as a reward. Did you know that you can give gifts to people? To give someone a gift, talk to them while holding what you want to give them. If the present is something they'll like, they'll be happy. You'll become closer friends and they'll like you more. But if you give them something they hate, they'll like you less. You're worried you'll give someone something they hate? Don't worry, kiddo. Even if you don't give gifts to people, just talk to them to become better friends. If you talk to them every day, you'll learn the things they like and dislike. Since you did such a great job, I have a reward for you. Yep, 2 potato seeds. I know you're going to be great at this, kiddo. Do your best. Now, on half rainy days, people's shops will still be open. And the one thing I want is a parasol. Now, usually parasols are like, just for keeping the sun out of your eyes, not for rain, but these are actually parasols you can use in the rain as well. And you can do it like this. Yay! Alright. Now, it's Tuesday, so Yun's tea shop is actually closed. Even though it is, though, apparently Gonbei still comes in here. Which is... it's not that weird. He actually likes old friends with Yun, so... This book is called Befriending Wild Animals. Read this book. Yes. The wild animals on the mountain are really cute, aren't they? I think my favorite are the bears. Bears are so adorable, but it wasn't easy for me to become friendly with the bear I saw. The first time I tried to get close, he slammed into me. That was a shock. It made my head spin, but that didn't stop me from liking bears. Every day I tried to talk to him, but the bear still wouldn't open his heart to me. So I tried to bring the bear some food to eat. But when I got close, he just body slammed me again. So I tried leaving the food near the bear and watching from a distance. And it worked. The bear happily ate all the food I left for him. So I kept on giving food to the bear, and now, sometimes the bear comes over and gives me a present. Now we're the best of friends. But the other day, I accidentally hit the bear with a farm tool. And the bear told me it was so startled it hated me for a bit. Animals hate to be hit with things or when you throw things in the river. So be careful when you're using tools near animals. And try not to drop things into the river. Okay, I'm going to try hard to be friends with some of the other animals too. That's actually Ying's writing. Because she likes being friends with stuff, so... there we go. So what I want to do is find where my cart is, and once again, drop the stuff that's super fresh into storage. Now this cart that I have is not very, it doesn't keep things fresh for long, but that's because it's just, a bog standard cart. You can get carts that preserve the freshness for a lot longer. Welcome to Kanna's Animals. Take your time and have a look around. Look at the horse carts. Now you can buy a horse cart for 5,000. This has a storage of 4. Or you can upgrade your own cart to carry more. You can also rent another horse. This only becomes appropriate when you get bigger carts that require more, like a bigger horse to ride. But we won't be able to do that until the tunnel starts getting opened up. And you can buy pets too. But because we don't have any animals, now what we are going to do is we're actually going to go deposit what we said we were going to into the shipping bin, which is the rice flour. We also want to dump the honeycombs into there as well, because it's another way of getting some cheap money. In Bluebell, if you were If you're going in Bluebell first, I would recommend that you keep hold of any honeycombs you find. Because, on the one of the farm upgrades for Bluebell is to get beehives. And you need honeycombs to seed them. But in Konohana, I just sell them. Because I start in Konohana, I just sell them for extra money. So we're actually going to go down and visit Bluebell. Now we're not actually going to go down for a proper visit. We're actually going down because I actually have something I want to go buy. Alright, now this little girl here is Cheryl, Ash's little sister. This is their mother, Jessica, and she sells the livestock, and Jessica sells the food and treats that you will need for your animals. So I want to buy an animal, we want to buy a chicken. Now my first chicken always gets called Alfred because I was a big fan of Alfred the Chicken game that I used to play on the Amiga. So she's going to teach us how, right, it's a tutorial stuff. I know how to take care of a chicken. These chicks, when they grow up into chickens, can hatch more chicks. If you want your chickens to hatch chicks, come see me. Keep in mind that only healthy adult chickens can hatch chicks. Pretty much all of the livestock in the Harvest Moon games, at least this one, are female. Alright, never mind. Now, I can't actually buy a cow yet because I don't have enough. But I also want to buy some chicken feed just in case we have any full rainy days. Because chickens and cows, at least in this game, you can take them out to, take them out of the barn and put them in the field so that they can graze. But on full rainy days, or they will not be able to go out because they hate rain. So you, even on half rainy days, if it starts raining, you gotta put your livestock back in the barn so that they don't get too distressed. On a full rainy day, however, you can't let them out to graze whatsoever, so that's where fodder and chicken feed come in to play. Alright, come by any time. Okay. So we just want one chick. Right, this woman here. This is Elaine. She is the one that will help us upgrade. This is Diego. He's the one that wears purple. Remember, he's one of the triplets. And here is his brother Enrique. Right, now let's see. Here's Ash, Cheryl's older brother. Alright, let's see if I can find... Here's Georgia. Georgia? George? Georgie? Whatever. I can never remember how to pronounce a fucking name. This is Grady, her father. Georgia. This is Lainey. And the only person that will actually sell on full rainy days, I believe, is Cam. He's the flower shop owner. And here is Howard. He's Lainey's father. And Here's Rutger, obviously. And here is his mother, Rose. It's either his mother or his wife. I can't remember which. But as you can see, they have a statue of a chicken on a sheep on a cow. Which I always found amusing. And here is the Church of the Harvest Moon. Harvest Goddess, rather. But the thing about it is, like, there's the statue of the Harvest Goddess. There's nobody here now, but that is because Nathan is not here yet. I don't know exactly when he comes. I think it's like in winter or something. I'm not sure, but Nathan will show up to run the church eventually. He's not the only one that will, like, show up. Like, there are quite a few villagers that will not show up for quite some time. Two of them are actually... No, three? Four of them that show up later on are actually secret bachelors and bachelorettes. Get back on the horse. Let's just get back home. Unfortunately, we can't, because it's raining, we can't water our plants for a second time, so that's just the way it goes. So we'll press R to put our cart away. The horse will go back in automatically. And we shall go to sleep. And that is day 3. And I cannot believe how long these episodes are actually taking. As I said, this is tutorial stuff. So... mainly tutorial stuff. But now we've met pretty much everyone we can from Bluebell. We've done the majority of the tutorial quests. I think we've done all of the tutorial requests now. And tomorrow, we will be able to go to Gombe's to buy some seeds for the first time. So, until then, farewell, my friends, and I will see you soon.